you're coming to the book box too?
Yeah, you too. I just found it today.
Same. I borrowed a book, so I was bringing one to give back. That's what you're supposed to do.
Do you mind if we trade books? We can always bring them back to the box later.
Sounds great. Here.
You know, it's a nice day. Want to go read together for a while?
Sure. So, where do you go to school anyway?
Oh, I just go to that school called Sail down the block. What about you?
Welcome to eveRIAthing. Today on our show, we have a very young boy who is aspiring to be a known actor as well as scientist, because he does love not only acting but quantum physics. And he may be very, very young in his scenes and on camera, but he has a very serious attitude towards saving the environment and wildlife. So ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Aiden Cumming-Teicher.
I'm good, thank you.
Good, yeah, I like your very dressed today.
I like the clash between the shirt and the tie.
It's nice. I think it stands out. It helps the tie to really pop, you know? Yeah, very, very mature. Yeah, I feel like we're having like a business meeting right now. Very, very cool. High tech, yeah. So tell me, you're into science, right? You want to be a scientist. Yeah. You like quantum physics. I took biology because it's the easiest course that there is. So tell me, what is it that you like about quantum physics?
Well, I love the uncertainty. Werner Heisenberg made a principle called the uncertainty principle, and what it says is you cannot determine the velocity and the position of any one particle, because a particle acts like a wave. You can create a wave packet to try and determine both, or at least get close to them, by overlapping these waves, and the more you overlap, the smaller wave packet you have, therefore making it easier to find the position, because there's less spaces in that packet the position could be, but making it harder to find the velocity within that. However, if you blew it up by using less waves, you cannot find the position as easily, but the velocity will be easier to find.
You lost me at the uncertainty. I can't find my own velocity of understanding quantum physics. So I know you were also the narrator for Written. Can you tell me what it was like narrating something? And, you know, as a narrator, you're working with a script and you can't usually see what the outcome is right away. So what was it like for you having to relate to this and be able to emotionally deliver it without seeing the actual presentation?
Well, the challenges were that you can't visualize it or use expressions or body language. You have to do all that emotion purely through the voice. But one advantage of doing voiceover and the storytelling in that way is that you have the script on hand, so you can focus more on delivering your voice better.
Mm, very good, very good. And what would you say are the challenges between delivering your voice versus delivering acting physically?
Well, for acting, normally, you can rely on your voice to a certain degree, but you still gotta bring it with your body, and that is hard in itself. You have to really feel the character in order to do that. In voice acting, you only need to have one part of that, but you have to make it really good because you don't have the others to improve your performance.
Mm, yeah. So obviously that's one of the few, many performances that you've had that has gotten you recognized in the acting world. I know that I met you at the Joey's and you got a medal, right, an award. And you also brought another award here today that's from LA, from the Young Entertainer Awards. So why don't you tell me a little bit more about your nominations and awards over the past few years?
Well, it's only been a year and a half, surprisingly. But as you know, at the Joey's, I was nominated for Written in a short film I did called Lou. And I didn't win, but I got this nice medal. Mm-hmm. And I was nominated for the Young Entertainer Awards first annual gala in LA for Lou. And, wow, we were surprised. Like,
We came there because originally we weren't going to, but we decided, it's a nice experience. It'll be fun. And then my name was called, and I couldn't believe it. I just ran up to the stage, thinking maybe it was a mistake, and I got to get this before they can change it. So, yeah.
It was a good experience to have as well, and being recognized as a Canadian actor in, you know, the U.S. is a very, very big step.
So sharp today, and you just won in your category. Can you tell everyone what you just won?
I won for boys under, in a short film, under ages 10 and under, though I'm now 11. Oh. And I won for Luke.
Congratulations! That is such a big deal, so are you super excited to celebrate later?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, what are you going to do to celebrate?
Probably just go to Universal Studios and spend a splurge in the anthem.
Oh, I see. Great plan, right, parents?
I know that aside from acting and you know, being a quantum physicist, you're also a very passionate environmentalist. Yeah. And last July, you were at the Cowichan River and you were going there to help save 2,000 salmon fry. Tell me a little bit more about this experience and what drove you to help and save rivers and wildlife.
Well, my grandfather has very much taken a lead in the Cowichan wildlife, and he's responsible for a lot of things. He's trying to fundraise. So he asked me if I wanted to come out, and I was more than happy to.
Wonderful, yeah. And what was it like for you being able to do something good for the environment?
It was really inwardly gratifying being able to help what most people don't think they can.
Mm-hmm.
And helping people know that they can do it.
Yeah, and I think that's a very important thing too, is that a lot of people are discouraged because they're hesitant on doing things. So the fact that there are people like you, especially at your age, so young, going out there to help make differences in the world, it's really nice to see. Especially, I don't think it's hitting many people about environmental change until just now, that there's global warming that's coming into effect, and maybe had we done something about it sooner, we wouldn't be dealing with this. So it's nice that at least now, better late than never kind of thing, right? Yeah.
This is the Cowichan River in Vancouver Island, and it is especially dear to me because I go there every year. Every summer, I get to enjoy how amazing it is to live in beautiful British Columbia, to fish, swim, and tube in the river. However, for the past few years, the water keeps getting lower and lower, and the weather keeps getting hotter and hotter.
Stewardship means responsibly taking care of resources, not wasting water, and preserving those natural resources for my grandchildren to enjoy, just as I have enjoyed them with my grandfather.
All the wildlife and people in the area enjoy this wonderful, life-giving river. This year, the water was so low in places, I could walk across it. Every year, it gets lower and lower. Can you imagine all those puddles of water drying up as thousands of fish die? You can see the fish in here are very stressed out. We went in with special nets to gently fish them out and carefully transport them in buckets. We had to separate them, clip their tails, and sent them for DNA testing. The fry in the buckets got a second chance. You can see how we sort them into the buckets with the net. The buckets are full of water and fry are very heavy, so I needed some help. There are only a few of us, and we're out there several hours. We managed to save about 2,000 salmon fry. The water in the bucket is a different temperature than that of the river, so if you let them out too quickly, the fish can go into shock and die. You can see them! Look at all the little guys having a second chance at life! You should care about keeping these wonderful rivers and lakes around for your generation, your kids' generation, and your grandkids' generation. I want to be able to enjoy them for many years to come.
Tell me, how do you push your advocacies at such a young age?
Well, I try and I go and I make it public. And so I don't want to just do it. That's all great and you should be doing that. But you got to let people know so they can do it too.
Yeah.
I push and I push for what I think the world needs. Not just what I need, but the world needs.
That's good. Yeah, and that's really important too, to that you're promoting it yourself. What are some values that you think you can share with other kids about your experience and, you know, being so young and being able to help out the world?
Two things. One, believe in yourself. You can help. And two, most of all, work hard. You can't just like half-heartedly do this. It's just not something you do. Yeah. You have to go at this full tilt.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Can you tell me a little bit more about, you know, since we're expanding on you helping the environment, helping the world, you're at the Tikkum Alum and how you're helping heal the world and at one bit at a time, you're doing it at such a young age.
In Judaism, we believe that a long, long, long time ago, the world broke, and it's up to each person coming into this world to put a piece back, because mm-hmm. it's shattered. And so the idea is that you should leave the world better than you left it, and I try to do my best.
Yeah.
You can put more than one piece. It's not limited to one.
I mean, that's a very beautiful thing to believe, yeah. So lastly, where can we find out more information about you, like on social media, or even if there are any fundraisers or things that you can promote for us to help the environment?
Well, you can find me on Facebook as Aiden Cumming-Teicher, Twitter as Super Aiden Land. You can find me on Instagram. I just opened an Instagram account. Don't know what it's going to be called yet. You can also find me on AidenCumming-Teicher.com. And one organization that I like to help fund the wildlife is Earth Rangers.
Wonderful. All right, so guys, be sure to check that out. We're going to be back after a quick break, and we're going to have some fun with Aiden. Stay tuned and keep watching. This is eveRIAthing.
I want the song to be good. I want to like the song. I want it to move me emotionally.
What a song needs to have is a hook, a memorable hook. Something that people can relate to, something that's current, you know, that's can cross different genres, boundaries, race, color, creed, you know, all the different things that anybody who, no matter what country they're from, they can relate to.
The STAR Experience is a really great opportunity for young people to be able to get in front of mentors and people who are able to steer them in the right direction, help them with the craft of their songwriting, with their singing, with all the aspects that will help their talent grow and flourish and put them in a position where they're able to have people help them and move them forward.
I think it's both the emotion that you can convey and how your audience receives that and how they connect with that emotion, right? So if what you're singing, if your audience really feels that and is there with you on that journey, that's what it is, you know?
So I think just be genuine and don't you know, force anything, just be yourself when you're writing your lyrics. Make sure it's genuine, make sure it's real and it's not contrived and make-believe, you know, like be genuine, and I think your fans will connect with that.
And the winner is, for third place,
Kathleen Monroe!
It's been like the best thing ever.
Oh,
because
yeah,
I've gotten to know you guys, so yeah.
Richard Tickleman! Woo!
It's still in me. I still can't get over it. It was such a cool experience.
Alexis Lynn.
Definitely do it. It's a great competition. I think it really helped me. Like, I'm here now.
Madison Bell.
Believe in yourself. I know it sounds cheesy. Everyone says it, but be true to who you are. That's also really, really cliche. But don't change who you are as a musician or what music you listen to because of what other people listen to. Stay true to who you are and what you listen to and do your best.
Dirty. Fish like give presents in there.
One fruit that would make you happy for the rest of your life.
Bananas.
Describe your mom in 3 words.
Awesome, nice, caring.
Your biggest fear is?
A rare disease coming to our family again.
Favorite movie?
Pacific Rim.
The best invention?
E=mc².
You love your best friend because?
He's like me.
You like green colored pants because?
I don't.
Why would you tell a person? Okay, we'll finish the last 2 questions. What would you tell a person who grabs your lunch from you?
Get the hell away.
The first thing that you would do if a puppy is crossing the street with a lot of cars?
I would grab it and run.
Very good answer, okay. Okay, so
now we have a workshop, and basically it's like charades. And what we have here is a bunch of different pieces in here. So we're going to take turns, like you go, and then I have to guess, and then I go, you have to guess. And what it is, we have to guess these things, and written on them are things that you shouldn't mention. So you can say what it is, so maybe not charades. You can say what it is as long as you don't mention the certain words.
Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors.
It was celebrated a few days ago. We celebrate... Yes!
Something about Fraser.
The Fraser Valley River? Fraser River? A river.
Fraser River.
Okay. Okay, so our next workshop is we have one paper each, so take one, but don't look at it yet. And basically, you have to name, you're going to say a color, and the other person has to name a natural resource that is of that color.
3, 2, 1.
White.
Snow. Brown.
Dog poop.
Okay, that'll work.
Green.
Grass. Black.
Cats.
Okay.
Yellow.
Yellow? The sun. Orange.
Tomatoes. No.
Oranges. But there is tomatoes that are orange.
That's true. To be fair, that is very true. Yay!
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much, Aiden, for coming in and sharing your wisdom with me. You're going to have to teach me quantum physics one of these days.
Yay! All right. Well, thank you guys for joining us today. I will see you next time here on eveRIAthing.
Personal favorites is I asked a man, what makes you happy? Tell me one thing that makes you happy in life. And he just looks back at me and he goes, only one thing?
We just do a lot of, like, all of the money that we get basically goes directly to the Amanda Todd Legacy Foundation, mm-hmm. and that is what funds all the programs for kids with learning disabilities and youth with mental health struggling in the communities. I mean, you find bullying in every aspect of life, no matter what, but sports, it's an outlet for kids is what it is, essentially.
Well, I work very hard, and I kind of, I approach acting as, like, it's a science. Like, I could get really technical with it, but for me, acting is about honesty. Also, it's about connecting with the other person in the scene. That is probably the biggest thing for me.
If you're in an audition room and you're feeling nervous, just remember that you have every right to be there as anyone else does. you're good. If you get called in for an audition, that means you're good and you deserve to be there. Never give up on your dream. I mean, I'm from Winnipeg. I never thought I'd be working with Daniel Radcliffe.
Well, up until The Returned, it was mostly commercial work. Mm-hmm. I recently did a film directed by Tim Burton called Big Eyes, and it was an actor role. That was a very memorable day because I don't mean to make you more jealous, but
were you with Lena?
No, I got a handshake from Tim Burton and a hug from Amy Adams. California sign, it's got nothing.